In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract features from one date column visually using Excel.
Hey data geeks, my name is Kunal. I help you master data science through non-linear methods of learning. So before we dive in, make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you never miss out on any of the awesome tricks to learn data science.
So let's get started. With me, I have data that is ID, target, two binary variables, one nominal variable, one ordinal variable, and two date variables. For this example, I'm going to use this date column to extract more features out of it. So let's look at the basic level features that we can extract using just one column visually that too using Excel. Now, with one date and the target data here, ID data here, let's see what we can do. Now, first, it's going to be very simple. We can extract year, month, and day. And to do that, we have the year function within Excel. This is the function that we have. I'm just going to copy this and paste special formulas. So this way, you can extract one particular feature from this date variable. Now, the year variable typically does not vary much. And so it might not be useful. But nonetheless, this is one way of extracting a feature from a date. Then we can extract month from it, which is again going to be a cyclic feature because it occurs 1 to 12 and within a cycle. So I'm going to take this one and paste special formulas. Similarly, I can extract day from this particular date using the day function. I'm going to copy that and paste special formulas. So with this three simple functions, you have extracted three different features already. Now let's take it further and extract few more basic features that are going to be helpful. Now, these are typically helpful in terms of a retail domain, wherever there is a lot of purchase and a lot of customer behavior. And so let's see how we can extract weekday. Weekday is going to be like Monday to Saturday or Sunday to Saturday type of format. Right, so it's going to be is equal to weekday, and I'm going to give a serial number, and in serial number within Excel, serial number would mean a date. So I gave that date, and the return type will be what? From Sunday through Saturday is one example, then from Monday through Sunday is one example, and you have different other examples, right? For simplicity, I'm going to choose this one, number one, numbers one through Sunday, one meaning Monday and seven meaning Sunday. So I'm going to choose that and say enter, and I'm going to change this to be Sunday. So that way I get the weekday, and I'm going to go and say paste special formulas, and I get all of these values here, right? So within Python also, you'll have the similar function and the similar attribute to help you choose what is the format that you want to use. Now, the next one is week number. You can use a week number function within Excel to extract the week number that is from 1 to 52 of the year, right? So I'm going to close this bracket, and you'll see that gives me the week number of that particular year. So one would mean it's the first week of January. And as you can see, we have 51, 52, which will be typically in December and towards the end. And this is how you get these weeks. So these are dependent on weeks to extract. And these are the two variants that we can extract using the single date. Now we have two other features, that is the quarterly and the half yearly extraction. And quarter would mean quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, and quarter four. And so to do this one, we can simply take the month of the date, right? And divide this by three to get a number. Now this number will be basically typically in decimals, and it will give us some number, right? So it'll give us some number like this. So if it is in December, definitely it's fourth quarter. If it is November, definitely it's going to be the fourth quarter. But as you can see that it's coming as 3.66, right? April comes in the second quarter, that is January, February, March, and the April enters into the quarter two. So definitely 1.33 should also be considered as two. So by looking at this pattern, we can safely assume that we can use a roundup method on top of this to get the exact quarter. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to say round up, comma, zero, no decimals within this particular data. I'm going to copy that and then paste it, paste special formulas. So now, if I remove the decimals here, you'll notice that I get each of the quarters from that particular date. This is how you extract quarter. It's a little tricky, but within Python, if you want to implement the same thing, you directly have a function that can help you do this one. Now, half year is again tricky and has some different logic to be applied. So we're going to now assume that from Jan to June is going to be first half and July to December is going to be second half. Now, depending on which company you are on or which domain you are in, this half year can change. That's why I'm saying for this particular example, we have chosen Jan to June and July to December as a baseline. So for this, we're going to begin by an if statement. That means we're going to extract the month. And we know that if this month value is from 1 to 6, that is less than or equal to 6, then it's going to be the first half, else it's going to be the second half. So I'm going to say less than or equal to 6 is going to be the first half, else it's going to be the second half. And this way, we'll be able to extract half year from this particular data. So there you have it, guys. This is how we can use one simple date column and extract simple features from that particular one feature using just Excel functions. And the similar logic can also be transferred to Python, SQL, R, or whichever platform you are in. You will definitely have a function that helps you, supports you to get these particular answers. Now, these are some of the basic features that you can extract. However, there are a lot of other features that you can extract, and I'm going to create another video with advanced features getting created using a single date. But for now, this is it for you to extract basic features from data, and this is going to be going to act as a foundation for a lot of customer analytics or a lot of analysis that you can do in terms of behavior and many other analysis possible. If you like this particular visual explanation of how to extract date features using Excel, then you are definitely going to like a video that I've created on how to extract the same features using Python and R. So I'll place a link for both of these videos within the description section. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.